Hello all. Today we are going to discuss in electronic circuit analysis and design online lecture, crystal oscillator. So let us see the outline. So today we are going to cover crystal oscillator in detail, but before that we'll see the topics which are here: crystal material, crystal properties, electrical equivalent circuit of a quartz crystal, then quartz crystal characteristics, the two resonant frequencies, then we'll study a crystal oscillator circuit, BJT based, and then last we'll study the Pierce crystal oscillator circuit. So let us directly begin with the topic. Okay, so first, before going to the crystal oscillator, first, we will see what are the limitations in a conventional RC or LC oscillator. LC oscillators are used to generate extremely high frequency oscillations, and RC oscillators are used as low frequency oscillators. But both have a common problem of frequency variation or frequency drift. So basically, oscillator frequency may drift or change due to change in temperature, change in power supply voltage, or change in various component values, for example, resistors, capacitors, even the active device such as transistor, FET, BJT, parameters also change. So the frequency stability is not so high. So hence we use a crystal oscillator, which is used in applications where very high level of frequency stability is required. It has a very high quality factor, greater than 1000, and it is used for generating stable clock frequency from 100 kilohertz to 100 megahertz. Only one limitation of crystal oscillator is there. It is non-tunable. That is, it is a fixed frequency oscillator. So now let me show you one application. Okay, this is one of the application of a crystal oscillator, that is quartz crystal oscillator. We use it in a microprocessor. I hope you have you studied about microprocessor before. So to generate the clock, we use this crystal, quartz crystal, which is used for extremely high frequency stability. So here it is written, one of the important features of any oscillator, it is frequency stability. That is, the frequency will not change under any conditions. So it is the ability to provide a constant frequency output under varying load conditions. So that is the property which quartz crystal obey sufficiently well. So now let us talk about the availability of crystal material. The crystal are naturally available in the following forms: Rolleike salt, tourmaline, quartz crystal. So basically, Rolleike salt is mechanically weak and has maximum vibrations. Tourmaline is mechanically strong but least vibration. Quartz crystal is the most preferred and it is easily available. Let us study quartz crystal in more details. Quartz crystal natural frequency is stable with temperature. Secondly, it is also stable with time. Now let us see the principle on which the quartz crystal works. So the quartz crystal works on the principle of inverse piezoelectric effect. That is, it exhibits electromechanical resonance. So let us see what is inverse piezoelectric effect. So whenever an external AC voltage, that is an electric field, is applied to a piezoelectric material, for example, a quartz crystal, the crystal starts vibrating at the same frequency as that of the input AC voltage. Next, we'll see the electrical equivalent circuit of a quartz crystal. So this is a quartz crystal, the symbol of a quartz crystal. Its quality factor is extremely high. Why it is high, we will also talk about that. And electrically, it is represented in this form. So it has internally represented by CS, LS, RS, and CP. CS, LS, and RS are in series. Okay, so this is the electrical equivalent circuit of a crystal. Now let us describe each of its component in detail. So your capacitance CES is called as a motional capacitance. It defines the elasticity, area of plates of the and the thickness of the quartz crystal. LS is representing motional inductance, which is defining the mechanical mass of the crystal when it is vibrating. RS is the series resistance, which defines the resistive loss. CP is the shunt capacitance, which defines the capacitance due to mechanical plates. As you can see, the crystal is represented by two mechanical plates over here. So that CP represents the shunt capacitance, which represents the mechanical plates. Now, basically, a quartz crystal is made up of a quartz oscillator is made up of piezoelectric crystal, and this crystal of quartz material have a very high degree of frequency stability. So characteristics we have seen it works on the inverse piezoelectric effect. So next we talk about the crystal impedance versus frequency. So basically, quartz crystal, one of the characteristics is it has two resonant frequency. One is called as series resonant frequency, other is called as parallel resonant frequency. So basically, in a series resonant frequency, the equivalent impedance is equal to R, and in case of parallel resonant, it is equal to Cm. So one resonant frequency occurs when the reactants of the series RLC leg are equal and opposite. So we can refer this circuit over here. So one resonant frequency occurs when the reactants of this series RLC leg are equal and opposite. So for this condition to be true, the series resonant impedance is very, very low, equal to R. And the other resonant condition occurs at a higher frequency when the reactants, this is at a higher frequency. That means that when the reactants of the series resonant leg is equal to the reactants of the capacitor. So this is a parallel resonant condition of the crystal. At this, let me just show you that. Okay. So at parallel resonant, the crystal offers a very high impedance to the external circuit. So to use the crystal properly, it must be connected in the circuit so that its low impedance is in the series resonant operating mode or high impedance in the parallel resonant operating mode is always selected. Now, quartz crystal act as a LC tank circuit, hence can generate the oscillation at a specified frequency. It has two resonant frequencies as we have described just. Let me just keep it over here. Yeah. So it has two resonant frequency, that is FS and FP. Normally, your parallel resonant frequency is much higher compared to S, series resonant frequency. As you can see in this curve, all the frequencies below FS, the crystal impedance is capacitive. Between FS and FP, that is the series and parallel resonant frequency, the crystal impedance is inductive. And beyond parallel resonant frequency, the crystal impedance is capacitive. So while selecting the quartz crystal for a specified application, we need to decide at which resonant frequency it is going to be operated. The series resonant frequency is given by this formula, 1 upon 2 pi square root of LS into CS. Now, what is LS and CS? LS and CS is in this diagram, the equivalent circuit. And this is the series resonant frequency. And we don't have the derivation for this. We are just showing you the formula. So the parallel resonant frequency FP is given by 1 upon 2 pi square root of LS into C equivalent, where C equivalent is CP CS upon CP plus CS. So this CP and this CS value over here. Now we'll concentrate on the crystal oscillator. Let me just open up another PDF so that we can... Uh, Okay, so our next topic is we use this crystal inside a oscillator circuit along with the amplifier. So this is a crystal oscillator employing BJT. So we have this R1, R2 as the biasing resistors. This is instead of RC, we have a radio frequency coil over here. And in the feedback part, you have this crystal and a coupling capacitor CC. And in the emitter part, you have RE and CE as usual. So this is a crystal control oscillator using a crystal in a series feedback part. Let me just reduce this so that we can view this thing all the time. So above circuit is a series resonant circuitry. So crystal will operate at a series resonant frequency. In this circuit, the crystal is connected in as a series element in the feedback part from the collector to the base. This is done to excite the crystal for operating in the series resonant mode. So at the series resonant frequency, its impedance is the smallest and the amount of positive feedback will be the largest. So the resistors R1, R2 and RE will provide the voltage divider and the necessary stability operating point. Capacitor CE is to provide AC bypass to any oscillations to the ground. RFC coil establishes the DC bias while decoupling any AC signal on the power lines affecting the output signal. So again, this circuit is powered with a DC power source only. Capacitor C, coupling capacitor CC, has negligible impedance at the circuit operating frequency and it also blocks any DC signal between the collector and the base. The circuit operates at the frequency which is set by the resonant frequency of the crystal and its value is given by Fs is equal to 1 upon 2 pi square root of L into C. So at Fs, we have minimum impedance so that the feedback will be maximum. So by setting the gain at Fs, we can use this circuit to generate sustained oscillations. So the voltage feedback from the collector to the base is a maximum when the crystal impedance is minimum. So the resulting circuit over here, which you can see, the oscillations are set up and that's how you have a crystal oscillator. So the advantage of this circuit is the changes in the supply voltage, transistor device parameters have no effect on the crystal oscillating frequency. So next we will see another Pierce crystal oscillator. Pierce crystal oscillator. Here the crystal oscillator is working as a parallel resonant circuitry. So as you can see, this circuit is similar to a Colpitts oscillator. In place of an inductor, we have connected a crystal. So here the crystal acts as the inductor over here. So here L3 is replaced by crystal. Piezoelectric crystal is used as a resonant circuit replacing an LC. So this is acting as a LC tank circuit only. Only that the crystal gives you extremely high frequency stability. So crystal is made to operate as an inductor. So this is possible if the frequency of oscillations omega is adjusted between Fs and Fp, which we have earlier defined. The basic operation remains the same as a normal Colpitts oscillator. The radio frequency coil can be connected which connects the DC power supply to the circuit, but isolates the DC power supply from the high frequency oscillations generated in the tank circuit. The advantage over here is the crystal has a very high quality factor as a resonant circuit, which results in a very high or very good frequency stability. So advantages are very high frequency stability, the very high quality factor, and applications of a crystal oscillator. Well, we have already discussed one. It is acts as a crystal clock in microprocessors. It is also used in frequency synthesizers, in the radio and television transmitters. More often than not, quartz crystal is also used in digital watches. So that's it for today's lecture. Next time, we'll see another topic. Thank you.